trash him to Beamer. And I think Beamer's already done a good job, you know, winning the press conference, winning the media availability, all that kind of stuff. Heath Klein was talking about that on Brad's show earlier. So I think the culture is going to be better. The buy-in is going to be better. You get Marshawn Lloyd back, who had the ACL injury last year, very talented freshman, and you get Kevin Harris back. So I think you're going to have a very good running back duo. Doty, to me, is going to be more serviceable than what you had last year with Colin Hill and Helinski and all that. And he's probably going to have a lot more time to get comfortable, develop, take first team reps, all that stuff. And then you look at the schedule, Falk. I like the schedule for South Carolina. If the number's four, you just got to win five. Eastern Illinois, at ECU, I don't know why they're going on the road, at ECU, I think those are wins.
Going to John Heights, ECU, Greenville, North Carolina.
Sure. I'm going to give them a win. You can just run the ball all over ECU. Troy, Vandy, that's four. That's four right there that I feel like I can take to the bank. And then you just got to get one more. Can you beat Kentucky? Can you beat Tennessee? Can you beat Missouri?
On the road.
Those are on the road, I know. Auburn. And that's where there's a little pushback there. But I think this culture is going to be in a much better place than it was with Muschamp. And I love the running back duo. Give me this running back duo that you can rely on in Kevin Harris and Marshawn Lloyd. South Carolina over the four.
Kelly, I think they can get 2-4. I have a hard time seeing where the fifth win is, but I like
that's the smartest thing I've ever heard her say, and he's a fucking idiot.
Like, guaranteed.
He can't win four games.
I think it's very possible.
Tennessee.
I'm going to go quickly.
Tennessee.
Tennessee. Over four.